Good thing I show you how to tie a spinner rig, a crawler harness. Use it Lake Erie or using the Mississippi River too. It's a spinner rig that put a night crawler on. It has multiple hooks. I'll show you one here that's already done. This is similar to the one I cut two walleyes over 11 pounds on Lake Erie. It's what I use. I put heavier line on this one. I was going to give that a try out Lake Erie. Usually I use lighter line, like a 12 pound test. But you have a swivel and about 24 inches, 30 inches of line. Here's the rig. It has two hooks on it. Hook back there. And the stinger hook back here is tied on with a braided line. You can hardly see it because it's small. The hook up here, the big hook, is a Gamogachi hook. I use those. They're expensive, but they're light. And being light, I can get away with just using beads on here, and it'll stay. It really won't float, but it won't sink to the bottom very fast. It just kind of stays buoyant. It sinks real slow because I use a pretty big blade on here, and that makes it sink. But I had enough beads on here to keep the blade from hitting the hook, and that way it keeps on spinning. And if I use a smaller blade, then I use less beads. And for the clevis to hold the blade on, you can take the blades off and put them right back on, change blades, change colors, change sizes, just snaps right off, snaps right back on. These plastic clevises don't do any damage to your line. They can spin all day and they won't hurt your line anywhere. The metal ones will cut into your line. And above that, I put one more bead just to help keep the blade down in place. And that's it. This is the rig I cut two walleyes over 11 pounds on, using clip-on sinkers with these while drifting and trolling. And what you do is feed this thing out about 30 feet, 20 feet. And then up on your line, you attach a clip-on sinker. And the clip-on sinker will be far enough away from this thing that it won't spook the fish. For one thing, it won't spook the fish. Another thing, when you're fighting a fish, the sinker will come up ahead of the fish enough that where you don't have a fish alongside the boat flopping, the fish is down in the water, and so it gives you time to unclip the clip-on sinker without losing the fish. Put a crawler on there, drop it out, feed it out about 30 feet. Then you need to attach a clip-on sinker. So I'm going to show you how you do that, how easy it is. First, I'm going to take a rubber band and just lay it across the line and run one end through the other. So lay it across the line, run one end right through the other, easy. And then that makes this little knot. Go ahead and pull that tight. When you pull that tight, that won't slide down. And like other clip-on sinkers and hurt your line, it won't do it. And also it'll give you bouncing action. Give you bouncing action. And it has a lot of good benefits. It's easy to clip, unclip, and the best thing of all, it's cheap. You can make your own, or you can buy mine. A big clip for the 2 ounce, and I use a small clip for the 1 ounce. But I really like this big clip because it's a lot easier to clip and unclip while you're fighting a fish. Clip with some stainless, small gauge stainless steel wire. I fold it in half and attach it, and then that makes it walk on two legs, which for bottom bouncing with a slip sinker that keeps the sinker from spinning around. And when you get these, you kind of have to open them up a little bit, straighten them out just a little bit, because I have to really bend those to get them in the package to wrap them up and clip them on and make a circle out of it. So kind of undo it a little bit, and so it should look like that, like it's going to lock the bottom. And then paint it neutral color so it doesn't spook the fish. Anyway, you take this clip-on sinker, and here's your fishing line. You feed out 30 feet with a spinner rig or crankbait, attach this rubber band, and here's your line. Then you just clip the sinker right under the rubber band like that. That's all there is to it. this will bounce and give you good action. And then you fish, and then after you catch a fish and you reel it in, the sinker will come up. And so when the sinker comes up, you just grab it and then unclip it, just like that. Drop it in the boat, or clip it right to the boat carpet, and then you know where it is and it won't bounce off in the water where you're running. And this thing just has so many good benefits to it. And then the rubber band here, you just ignore the rubber band, and it'll go right through your rod eyes. So just ignore it, it'll go right in through your rod eyes. And then when you get ready to start fishing again, just feed out your line, the rubber band will come out, the rubber band will let you know exactly where you were before, an excellent line marker, and you use it again. Just clip the sinker onto it. And this thing will last all day, and maybe several days, but change it about every day. And don't leave the rubber band sit out in the sun, or it will rot the rubber bands. And that's all there is to it. You can buy these for around $2 a piece on my website or eBay. eBay is Fish Head Tackle with two H's in the fish head. Fish Head Tackle. And fishheadtackle.com is my website.